So my workshop has a lot of work to do, unfortunately. I've started to kind of chip away at it. I ripped all the skirting boards off because they were water damaged, so I'm gonna get new skirting boards. I've tried to scrape up a lot of the dirt and mud, but I'm gonna gurney it. I'm gonna get a new toilet seat. I've got all these spare tiles I just don't even know what to do with. Slowly getting there. I have a lot of work to do before I even begin to think about epoxying. I'm gonna seal all the edges with sicker flicker something. I don't know, some sealant. Yeah, I've got loads of work to do, but I'm excited and I'm getting rid of that door. There is some water damage in here, unfortunately, so I'm gonna have to do a moisture barrier before I epoxy. So, step by step, we are getting there, and I cannot wait for this all to be done and turn into my workshop and make monsters. Yeah, now I'm off to the pub. Good morning. Just wanted to update on this shed situation. I used acid. I went there. I used the hard stuff, and it's actually come up pretty good. There's still so much stain in there, but I think I've gotten most of it out and stormy. So my next move is to angle grind out these cracks, patch them, and then seal the edge of the garage. Yeah, Stormy. I did it. So, super productive day. I've sealed the whole edge of the shed. I've patched and I'll grind it and then patched the concrete. I am now cutting the board, getting ready to paint this, and think I'm just gonna get rid of that door and paint all that black. But I think I'm gonna epoxy before I put the skirting board on. Yeah. Oh, do it yourself things, love it. So, since so many of you guys are following this journey, just wanted to show you, this is the edge of the shed, but there's a massive gap and it goes down into dirt. So I've got this back channel foam, it's called. You can wedge it right in there and it foams back up to the space. And obviously I'm going around the edge with this Sikaflex Pro sealant. I am going to go on the top of this with this, just extra seal everything out because I do not want any water getting in here after I epoxy. And this corner is the bitch corner because I have water. This is a water pump running from the water tank outside. It helps run the toilet and the sink in there. So I can't really disconnect it to epoxy. So I've got this tile that I am going to make black, like epoxy, and have here with this on it because, yeah, it's the bitch corner. It's really frustrating. Good morning. So today is another big day in the workshop working and setting it up. I bought this moisture seal barrier, which is like a floor primer, I guess, for epoxy. But this shed has had so much damage done to it. When I first bought it, it was like flooded out all in this area. I bought a moisture reader in this area. It is still reading over 20% moisture in that area, and I've had it drying for over a week. So I just don't want to risk ruining the epoxy floor for it. So I bought the moisture barrier kit. I'm going to do two coats of it over the whole shed just to protect it. And then, yeah, then I can start epoxying finally. What a process! It's going to be very rewarding. So, yesterday I posted about the water pump. I can't move it, I can't unhook it. I just like to epoxy under. This is it. But some genius had an idea to tie it up with a rope and hang it off the roof.
I don't know where to tie the rope, though. Huh. But I'm gonna try. Yeah. Look at my hands. Shit.
It's okay, don't stress. I think I found an area. There is a slight gap right there that the rope can fit in. And then I'm gonna like lever it all to lift this. Oh my God. It's like, stay tuned. All right, I'm gonna fucking try and lift this stupid fucking thing up. Right. There. It's up. Now I don't know where to tie this stupid thing. At least it's off the ground and I can epoxy underneath now. I just have to figure out where to tie it. At least I did it. Oh my God. I'm actually losing my fucking mind doing this shit. I did it. I did it. Stormy. I did it. I did it. I did it. So now I am about to remove this door because the bottom of it is water damaged and it's going to scrape up my brand new epoxy floor and we can't have that. So fucking remove the door. I've taped up those areas just because obviously I don't want eventually to have epoxy up on them. These areas I don't care because I ripped all the skirting boards off. I've cut all the skirting boards ready to go. And now I am just sweeping up any excess dirt and then I'm going to blow it all out, use a blower and get rid of any other dirt that I've missed, and then I'm going to start sealing it with this. Can't wait. So I'm nearly finished. Oh my god, my arms are like shaking right now. You can tell I'm not fit, but this is the Bostik moisture barrier that I've used. I'm going to start epoxying. I'll probably give this a day to dry. But yeah, I'm nearly done. And I've actually gone through the whole 10 liters that I bought. So I'm hoping I don't need a second coat because I can't.